Aliens at sea? November 2004, the USS Nimitz strike group is training off the coast of San Diego, California. For more than a week, newly equipped radar devices have been picking up strange blips on the horizon. Aircraft capable of descending 60,000 feet in less than a second. They assume the upgraded radar is malfunctioning, but the blips keep coming back. Commander David Fravor and his weapons systems operator are instructed to pull out of a training mission and fly their fighter jets over to investigate. Accompanied by another jet, four sets of eyes whiz over the calm seas. It's a clear day, maximum visibility. What they see as they approach the target coordinates will change them forever, and will become known as the Nimitz Incident. Could it be? Possible alien encounters have bubbled up throughout human history. They raise some of the most profound questions. Are we alone? Are we being watched? Are they among us? What do they know? What are they capable of? Aliens hold a special place in our psyche and in our culture. We've all looked up in the night sky and wondered, what if? Recently, it's been looking more and more likely that aliens are among us. Government agencies around the world are beginning to be more open about it. The former director of America's Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program, or AATIP, which was formed to analyze unidentified flying objects seen by the US military, is quoted as saying, "What once was considered science fiction is now science fact." Specialized alien scholars, known as ancient astronaut theorists, believe that alien visits to Earth in the distant past may be the root cause of human intelligence and consciousness as we know it. The answer to how we went from hunting and foraging to civilization and society. What would you say if you could capture that moment of origin for yourself? If you could experience it? If you could tap into ancient alien knowledge and expand your mind, your perspective, and your spirit? Can the secrets of the cosmos be revealed to you on a personal level? You'll be surprised by just how easy it is to enhance your understanding of the universe and your place within it. But first, let's get back to Commander Fravor flying his fighter jet over the California ocean. As Commander Fravor's team reached the UFO's coordinates, they noticed a patch of boiling ocean water. Above the boil by 50 feet, a small, white, pill-shaped aircraft, no wings, no cockpit. Fravor called it a tic-tac. Fravor descended to take a closer look. As he did, the tic-tac began rising up. Just as they were about the same altitude, the tic-tac vanished. Over their radios, Fravor was instructed to rendezvous at a meeting point. As if the tic-tac had intercepted the radio command, the UFO reappeared at the meeting point on their radar. By the time they arrived, it had vanished again. Fravor has said, "I don't know who's building it, who's got the technology, who's got the brains. But there's something out there that was better than our airplane. It was aware we were there." How aware are we though? How aware are you? Is it possible that alien civilizations gave humans our intelligence? Perhaps some answers can be found on 6,000-year-old Mesopotamian tablets. In the mid-1800s, archaeologists discovered artifacts that document ancient creation mythologies. Throughout these artworks were detailed accounts of humanoid divine beings called the Anunnaki, who were said to have descended from the sky. In fact, the word Anunnaki translates to "those who from heaven to earth come." Many historians believe the religions we know today were based on the Anunnaki, but ancient astronaut theorists believe the Anunnaki were real, physical beings who traveled to Earth and seeded early humans with the gifts of intelligence and consciousness to create a better version of our species. Could this be possible? Could the advanced evolution of our species have been helped along by alien visitors? The historical record seems to suggest it's not as far-fetched as it may sound. One Mesopotamian clay tablet dating back 4,500 years shows a full diagram of our solar system, complete with all the planets in their correct placement in relation to the sun. No telescopes, no satellites. How could the Sumerians have had such advanced astronomical knowledge? Thousands of years before modern science, unless a more advanced civilization had shared this information with them, it's simply not possible they could have guessed the placement of the planets. As we learn more and more about the alien encounters documented by militaries around the world, maybe we should be asking ourselves. Around the world, ancient artifacts have depicted non-human visitors to Earth. 5,000-year-old Australian cave paintings show creatures wearing spacesuits. 7,000-year-old Saharan paintings show spacemen leading natives. Mayan carvings show a humanoid operating a spacecraft. 14th century BC Egyptian hieroglyphs show advanced aircraft. The famous Lights of Dendera stone reliefs depict human figures next to giant light bulb objects, suggesting that alien visitors may have shown the Egyptians how to generate electricity. Could this explain how they constructed their amazing monuments? Knew that the planets orbit the sun and rotate on their axis, and even that some planets have rings and moons. What does it all mean? Could alien visitors through history have granted us wisdom, or potentially given us access or knowledge of some special compound or molecule that could open our minds to such knowledge? Maybe you've heard of the stoned ape theory. Ethnobotanist Terence McKenna's theory suggests that Homo erectus made the leap to Homo sapiens through the intake of substances like DMT. Alien astronaut theorists believe that it was alien visitors who introduced Homo erectus to substances like DMT in order to expand their mind through psychedelic experience. In other words, by consuming substances, ancient humans sped up evolution, quickening language development, music creation, spirituality, and complex thinking. Could it be aliens who gave us true consciousness and intelligence by unlocking our ancient, slower minds? Could they have returned through history with more sophisticated knowledge and information on each visit? Could shaman have had a direct connection with these aliens? Are we all but the result of an alien experiment? Is this the simulation that some people talk about? One thing we know for sure, the mind-opening effects of substances like DMT break down our brain's boundaries so we can experience alternate realities. Those who have tried it describe the experience as a journey to the core of their being, a vision quest that reimagines our self-awareness so that we can see ourselves, those around us, and our environment in a whole new light. Altering consciousness like this has helped millions to transcend their physical limitations, opening a portal to deeper parts of the mind. DMT is perhaps the best way to connect with all the otherworldly frequencies that lay beyond our normal awareness. What if you can tap into deeper knowledge? What if you can experience alien origins of the human mind? What if you can take your mind to where the aliens are? With substances like DMT, you don't need a spaceship to tap into ancient alien wisdom. You already have all the tools you need in your head. Think of your brain as a radio antenna. It's connected to the resonant frequencies of the universe. DMT allows the brain to amplify those signals so you can receive information that usually goes unperceived. By converting the molecular weight of DMT molecules, it is possible to emulate its natural frequency and target it on our bodies, tricking your body into thinking you've consumed DMT for real. The benefits of a substance without the substance itself. This is the power of frequency emulation. So, are you ready to discover what's on the other side? To go where the aliens are, your personal galactic awakening is just a frequency away. Learn more on dmtcoil.com.